from your own perspective, tell us, 2016, you know, is there a different spin that you have to how 2016 played out and what we could have done differently? Because I think at the end of the day, the lessons that we learn that will put us in better stead to move ahead.
Cyril has spoken a lot. And for me, I'd rather say it's not something that we didn't expect. The only thing was just the timing. The fact is that the issue about the country not preparing for the future, it's been something that is just like we never knew it was going to happen now. And if I take it further, it's more like, for me, I think it was more like something that needed to happen to wake us up. To keep having governments coming, not planning, not doing what they needed to do. I want to speak much from what Cyril has said. But looking at it, I think 2016, we didn't expect it to go the way it went. But I'll take it from the optimistic view, just the way you said. It also created a lot of opportunities. And I'll see it from the perspective of that. We needed something all the while, something to push us to begin to look inwards. And I think that foreign currency, liquidity challenge was really a key thing. I know recently I was discussing with somebody and I said, maybe perhaps this is also a time for us to begin to look at indigenous value, indigenous content. We've pushed this so much in the oil and gas sector, and we keep saying, oh, indigenous, indigenous. But the truth is that the oil and gas sector just is just a space. There's still a lot of other sectors. For instance, you know, a lot of times, one thing this will help was the fact that most of the things in shoring up our securities, across the various firms, most of the equipment we use are always imported. A lot of things we do, like in terms of own standards, the people doing the certification body are global. And you know the Nigerian thing, we always like things that are what? Global. But suddenly people made budget in 2015 to take care of 2016. They woke up in the middle of 2016 and discovered that, look, this budget was actually for 2014. What do I mean? So, you know, from my perspective as a security risk person, you keep telling management, you tell everybody, oh, we need to do this. Say, yes, yes, we need to do this. That's true. But first, it's in the budget. Yes, it's in the budget. Then they ask you, okay, how much did you actually budget? But suddenly with this Forex issue, you have things going to about three times the what? The value. So who coughs out the money? And I think the key point was that, at least the key lesson building on that was that it's time to begin to do what? Look inwards. So if we're talking about indigenous, participation in all the sectors, we need to drive this. I like to see, if you allow me to use this word, black consultants, Nigerian consultants, not just a normal, you understand what I mean? Because ultimately, you look at it, it apparently appears that these people just come around and feel, look, there's so much to make it. We are growing, but they're sitting there enjoying themselves, and sometimes like they come here for vacation and just take this bull for it out of the way. So I think that's a very, what they call it, critical lesson. I've taken it further again in terms of the regulatory issues. Let me put it as compliance. I think with regards to compliance, we also expected this. Because if you don't plan, things will happen suddenly like that. I don't want to take a mindset of always looking at things from the government perspective. And the reason is because I was listening to a radio comedy news short yesterday. And the guys were saying that I think it's time now for us to move from being, how do you call it, having governments, the 3 tiers of government, to begin to have government from the fatherhood perspective, which means every family becomes a local government, sort of. Because the truth is that, let's ask ourselves, even if we look a bit critical, you generate your water, you generate your electricity, you generate almost everything. The only thing you do to the government is that you pay tax. I hope this is not recorded, by the way. You understand my point. So, you know, when you begin to look at things that way, then you ask yourself that. The truth is that many times when you plan, it's actually best for you to plan, believing that the government exists in a vacuum, but the government is not really what? By you. So you need to make every arrangement, I mean, from the private sector perspective. So, and if I look at that again, it's also about looking what? Inwards. It's time for us to get to a point when we believe in ourselves and begin to even set the standards by our own self. Perhaps at least that will help a lot.